Hey everybody, have you heard about this combination? Windows 10, software update, and black screen. How to fix this? That's what we're learning today. Hey everybody, welcome back. This is the official YouTube channel of Recoverit, a fully functional professional grade software which is designed to recover your lost or accidentally deleted files or corrupted files from pretty much any kind of storage. And today we're back with more practical data solutions. If you like the idea, then subscribe to our channel. My name is Michael and I'm really happy to see you. Now, today's topic, black screen on your computer. And if we think about the possible reasons why it would appear, very often this could be caused by a Windows system update or another software or driver update. And since these are very generic reasons, let's see what we can do in order to fix it. As usual, we're going to start with something rather basic, hardware troubleshooting, and here things would depend whether you have a desktop computer or a laptop. Starting with a standalone desktop computer, more like a workstation, the thing you should first check is the communication between the computer itself and the monitor. Very often that's a cable, HDMI cable or VGA or DVI or DisplayPort. So try to reseat the cable in order to eliminate the possibility a cable issue to be preventing the monitor from proper operation. If we talk about a laptop, try to close the lid, open it again and figure out whether something does appear on the display. Easiest way to check, if you can reach out to the BIOS but you cannot see your operating system loading, then most likely that's really a software issue. If the monitor is working fine, then we continue to step number two. Have you ever heard of minimum supported hardware configuration? I'm asking you because this is exactly what we want to achieve here. It means we want to get rid of all the possible peripherals. Printers, mice, headphones, flash drives, external storage and so on. Just try to remove each and every component, make a power cycle. Did that help? Well, if not, we continue to method number three. Okay, this method is about drivers, but if you have a black screen and you want to update drivers, this could be a mission impossible. Therefore, one of the things that we could do is to try booting Windows in safe mode. And if you can't remember how to do this, check some of our other tutorials on the channel. Assuming that we already are in Windows safe mode, we're going to reach out to the device manager. We just need to highlight the graphics adapter, right-click, select properties, and go for the driver update. On the next screen, click search for drivers automatically. Make sure that your computer is connected to an internet connection during this process and wait until the result is positive. After the driver gets updated and the new one gets installed, all we have to do is to make a reboot and hopefully the problem is now fixed. If you're still in trouble, then don't worry because we have two more hardware-related ideas. Now, here in method 4, what we're going to do is to press a very specific sequence of keys in order to wake up the screen. So what we need to do is to press the Windows, Control, Shift and B keys simultaneously and release them once we hear a short beep. We gotta wait for a few seconds and our system is going to reboot normally. Does that help? Let me know in the comments below. Okay, last but not least, this is method 5 and I need to underline that this is only going to work in case those black screens appear sporadically, meaning that you can still access your computer and you can still launch your Windows operating system, but from time to time the image just disappears, like right now. Click the Start button, tap Settings. In the Settings window, select Update and Security and then select the Recovery tab. Now press Get Started under the Reset this PC option. Make sure to click the Keep My Files option, otherwise you're going to end up losing all your data during the process. Now wait for a few minutes, let the system restart automatically. Once it does, you hopefully won't see the black screen error any longer. So these have been 5 really useful tips and tricks which you can try in order to fix the condition where your computer shows a black screen. Now, during any of these steps, there always is the possibility that something further fails or possibly you have lost some really important data. Therefore, let me show you another bonus tip of how you can possibly recover your accidentally deleted or lost files during any of these operations. And we're going to use Wondershare's Recoverit. This is an advanced data recovery software which is going to perform a deep scan on your hard drive and restore all the deleted files within just few minutes. This time, I'm going to show you how to use Recoverit in offline mode. Therefore, you're going to have to install the software on another working computer and create bootable media. So all we have to do, start Recoverit on the working system and select System Crashed Computer mode from the main panel. Hit Start right after that, then choose the Bootable Drive mode and insert the bootable drive. Then click the Create button, which is going to erase all the data on your flash drive, but is going to copy the needed files to run Recoverit in offline mode. Once the bootable drive is ready, just eject it, plug it into the computer that we are about to recover, make sure to select USB drive as a first boot option, and follow the instructions in order to recover all your missing data. So all of that can be a little tricky, but following the right steps and procedures, you would easily be able to recover pretty much any kind of condition, and I hope that these 5 tutorials that we have shared with you about recovering from a black screen condition have helped you, and hopefully no files were lost during these operations. But even if they were, you can always count on Recoverit. You can also count on us for responding to all your questions, and we're looking forward to hearing from you. Did any of these steps help? And do you have any other suggestions? And for more practical data solutions, I invite you to subscribe to our channel. My name is Michael. Hope to see you very, very soon. Bye.